Good day, class. We're in crunch time here. It's just a few days away, a few hours, it seems like, from the 2020 presidential election in the United States. I know we have some overseas students, and I appreciate their time. We're having a presidential election this year. Surprise, if you didn't already hear about it. For me, I'm very into the presidents. One day I will be president, either in 2032 or sometime after then, because that's when I'm going to be eligible, at least. So I'm going to do a hat recap of some of the hats that I have that are presidential-related. I usually do this kind of thing for President's Day, but this is an election to determine either re-electing the incumbent, which is kind of a thing that usually happens, or does the challenger overcome the odds and beat the incumbent? Last time that happened was 1992. It doesn't really happen too often, actually. It's only happened just a few times in the 20th century. So it happened with Taft, it happened with Hoover, it happened with, well, not Johnson, it happened with Carter, and then Daddy Bush. Alright, let's get into the hats here, and we're going to start off with the big one here, one of my top 25 at least, for sure top 10 hats, my presidential seal, dad hat. This one I got straight from the White House gift shop website. I had to replace my old one that I got in a DC vacation trip from 2007, mold. I lost the buckle on the back, the metal loop to hold everything together. It was new president when Trump was sworn in, so I figured, you know, time for a new hat. This one, nice beige color. This one is pretty decorated. It's got Washington DC on the front of the brim. It has an American flag on the side, USA on the other side here, and on the back, just to make sure you knew where he lives, where the president lives, Washington, D.C. And, of course, the presidential seal on the front with the eagle holding the olive branches and the 13 arrows. And this one is just a nice dad hat. Pretty simple. One of my favorite ones. If you've seen my videos in the past, where I'm in my upstairs office, my bedroom, on my hat wall, this and my Concordia hat always have the same two spots on my hat wall. Very important hat, so I'm going to wear this throughout the rest of the video, just to let you know that I'm in charge. I will be one day, but, you know, got to wait for, you know, my time to come up. Move on to someone whose time would have been up, or it would have been their turn, but they just didn't make it through Super Tuesday. My Pete Buttigieg campaign hats. I have a bad tendency of getting, especially jerseys, but now hats, when, you know, a team or someone is doing good and then getting something to support them and then they fall off a cliff. One of my examples, I got an Atlanta Braves jersey. $50 on lids. They're up 3-1 in the NLCS 2020. They're going to win, going on to the World Series. They blew a 3-1 lead to the Dodgers, who would then later on win the World Series. So, yeah, I have the same problem now with hats, where I got this hat after Buttigieg won the Iowa caucus, like, barely. I mean, he technically won, but, you know, the Bernie Sanders supporters are going to throw a fit about that one. And I got the hat to support him. He was always on my mind, but I wanted to cement my support and get a hat for him. And this is a nice hat. It's made in the USA. American flag on the back here. Bayside Company, made in the USA. Made in South Bend, Indiana. Great way to support local businesses. And once I got the hat, about 2 weeks later, like the day before Super Tuesday, no, the Sunday before Super Tuesday, Buttigieg drops out of the race. So he was my favorite to go all the way. I mean, during the summer of 2019 when he had about 25 Democratic candidates trying to claw at each other to be the ticket holder for 2020 against Trump. I liked the idea of Buttigieg because he was young. He was kind of a moderate, even for a Democrat. He served in the Navy, and he was young. He was 37. I'm like, hey, I'm going to be 37 when I'm president, so I'll support the young guy. Valiant effort with Buttigieg, but didn't make it all the way through. Didn't even make it to Super Tuesday. Kind of sad, even after an Iowa caucus win. Oh, well. Next hat is Washington Nationals related, but kind of a DC aspect to it. This one I got on eBay a few weeks ago from when I'm filming. It's one of the 5950 fitted. It's got the nice skyline or kind of the backdrop of DC. Got the Capitol, the US Capitol Rotunda right there. I'm trying to point and show at the camera. It's got the Washington Monument, the obelisk, and then the Lincoln Memorial there. And I feel like they're hiding the White House in the background or behind the D.C. Word marking for the Nationals. But I've only visited D.C. one time. I want to go back there. It was only like maybe 12 at the time. I want to go back there. Have a new perspective on how to appreciate things. Of course, I appreciated things back then because I'm, you know, when I was little, when I started reading about the presidents, I wanted to visit these places. And for vacations, most families would go on, you know, summer vacations to Hawaii or to Florida or, you know, travel somewhere to just relax. My family, we chase dead presidents. So I, glad we got to go to DC one time. It was hot, but enjoyed my time there. Want to go back and enjoy it some more. Besides, I need to survey my future White House, you know. I want to make sure that the current guy, or whoever next, doesn't mess anything up in the house there, you know? If you know your minor league baseball history, then you'll know what these two hats are from New Hampshire. The New Hampshire Fisher Cats did a kind of contest, kind of a polling for their their minor league baseball team, for which hat to wear, for which uniform, because it's in 2016, presidential election, and the Fisher Cats took advantage of their status in the presidential campaign schedule. Whereas they are the second state in the whole schedule, you have Iowa, like I mentioned before with Buttigieg hat, Iowa caucus, which is more of a live voting process. It's interesting. And then New Hampshire, the next state, and they are the first primary state where it's just straight voting. New Hampshire did a little duo contest between a Republican and a Democratic hat for their minor league team. And I think the Democratic hat won, but I don't remember. But they designed these two hats for the team on the field, 50-on-50 fitted hats for New Era. Very, very solid hats. I love the design of these two. I'm a Republican, moderate Republican, and I got the Republican hat first, needed it first, and I knew I was going to get the Democratic hat one time, but it took me a while, so I want to thank Mr. ML Hats PHC for getting me the Democratic hat I've been looking for a while. It would have been on my lost hat list, but it's in my hands now. I really like the designs of these two hats. The donkey kind of has like a chill look in his face. The elephant kind of has a bit of a confident smirk. So, really great designs. Nothing too plain Jane about these two hats. I like the New Era flag on the sides. It's opposite colors. Red for the Democratic, blue for the Republican. And they're just great hats. I have these out for debate nights. Whether it be a all-Democratic or all-Republican debate, or if it's, you know, down to the final two candidates for incumbent Trump and challenger Joe Biden. So I always got a hat out for something. These two hats look the same. I mean, you can kind of tell already that this hat has a brighter coloring to the front stitches than this one. And this one, I kept the sticker on the front here for the New Era 950 snapback hats. So I forget where I got this one. This was the first one that I got. Pretty plain. Vote. And this was inspired, well, this one came from the 2016 New Era campaign collection. They did a whole collection of Democratic and Republican and campaign related hats, and they made this one, and I had to just find it. So I'm pretty sure I found it on eBay. This one is just, it's very simple. Vote. And every time I've worn this to a polling place, or whenever I just wear it out during campaign season for general elections, for primaries, for midterm elections, or just local elections, I always get at least a few compliments out of this one. I mean, this one is a great hat, but I mean, compared to this one, I mean, isn't it so much better? Billy, I know, yes, it looks the same, but it's not the same. Because see, with this hat, you get a black bottom here, pretty simple, pretty boring. But under here, whoa, all American flagged inside. Not only the brim, but the inside of the cap itself. Now, would this have been cooler on a fitted, maybe? Probably, but I'm glad it's on a snapback instead. At diversity. And this one, like, the inside is silk. It's very soft, very smooth, and it's not holographic. It seemed like that at first. It is made in China, ironically. And what I think is the coolest part about this hat is one of the stitching, or one of the patches on the inside. 1 of 100. 1 of 100. So there are only, in theory, at least to my knowledge, there's only 100 of these hats out there with this kind of patriotic design on the bottom. It's pretty rare. I mean, I know that like there are like rare 5950 hats out there, a lot of rare fitted hats, but this one is truly rare. It tells you verbatim, 1 of 100. I'm not trying to brag here, but I'd like to hear you in the comment section. You know, do you have a hat that you know is like, you know, unless it's like custom made, like I know I have like a custom Professor Hatter hat, you know. Now, this doesn't really count because you made it yourself, but something from New Era. Do you have something this rare? That'd be cool to know. It's a great fit, and you know, if I start to outgrow it, then I can always readjust it. This one I got a little bit more compliments on because the design underneath, I mean, this was back in 2016. So they were doing underbrim designs before the pink bottom, before the icy blue, before the red bottom, before Hat Club made it cool. So Hat Club is just trying to follow what they were doing for the snapback hat. So it's kind of fun. While I'm on the topic here, I don't want to tell you who, but I'm trying to release this video before the actual election. Go vote. Just effing vote. Just go vote. Well, I mean, MTS, I know that you're in Australia, so vote when you can, but for the American election here, for my American students, go vote. This isn't necessarily about the fate of the country, whether it's going to be 4 more years of chaos or the nightmare scenarioed 4 years of socialism in America. It's nothing about that. I am just simple patriotic. Just vote. Just vote for your... Vote for a presidential candidate, vote for your senator if need be, vote for local judges, vote for the referendums, vote for your House representative, your congressman, vote for everything. Well, do the best you can. I know sometimes I skip some of the judges because I don't know them, but I'm not telling you who to vote for, I'm just telling you to go vote. I know that sounds like I'm just dictating to you what you've been hearing across social media this whole last few months, but This is just simply just vote. Even if it wasn't this kind of holy crap year, I would still tell you to vote. If it was a normal non-pandemic year, vote. It's something that is just pretty simple. I know that some countries don't have it like we do in America. I mean, there's still some problems with the American voting system. I'm not talking about the electoral college system, but just talking about the general voting system of how people go about voting. But we'll get through that. We'll get through it. Somehow, some way, we'll get through it. I just encourage you to go vote. I don't care if you're going to vote for Trump, if you're going to vote for Biden, or if you're going to vote for a third party. Do not listen to anyone that says, oh, if you're going to do a write-in candidate, if you're going to vote for a third party, just throwing your vote away. Or you're just throwing your vote to Trump or to Biden because you want the other guy to win. No. As long as you vote, as long as you don't vote for Harambe, even Kanye, you did your civic duty. That's all I ask for. That's your homework. It's pretty simple. So just, if I haven't made it clear, do what the hat says. This is the big one. This is the new hat here. Billy, hand me the hat. Alright, and the new hat is going to be... Billy, did you just turn off the lights? Billy, how can they see the hat if the lights are off? Oh yeah! You're right, Billy. We're going to have a special video to reveal this hat. Wow, Billy, for once you're right. Wow, this is rare. I mean, I wish you could see the expression on my face on camera here, but the lights are off. Yeah, class, if you can hear me at least, then tune in soon for a big presidential hat reveal here. A big hat reveal that you won't want to miss. So I'll see you guys next time in that video, and have a good day, everyone. Class is dismissed.